second moon. Season of fire. To all of the guild keepers throughout the realm, I write this as I know I have been gone for some time, with the hopes of my return to share these interests in person. It feels like ages since I left the shores of Stormhaven, the smell of rain still haunting me. And even after being soaked in the darkness and crossing the autumnal portal, these winds still carry the scent of salt. But far and away am I now, to find myself beneath roots of trees, traversing tunnel after tunnel after tunnel in search of daybreak. My thoughts are beside me, and with them I can hear the whispers. Whispers, shadows flickering and dancing on the cavern's walls. They're reminding me of a time and a place fond in my memory. They're reminding me of the Long Lodge of Winterstead. Down below, the witch's presence is everywhere. and their hunger is growing greater. Hunting. They're hunting, and they're hunting for me. The centerpiece of their ravenous feast. But what are they waiting for? What are they bloody waiting for? The fires? The fires. The fires have them in fear. They're waiting for the darkness. Light the torches. Light them all and run. Run like a fox in the wind. Run and Godspeed yourself away from this nightmare. I saw a dark blue dot at the end of my subterranean path. And when I reached the opening of its damp and stony mouth, I could see the night sky, patched by clouds with the second moon's light dancing on their edges. As if to welcome me into this new land. A new land. Was the cavern itself a portal? Or was I dreaming? It was no matter now. I was free. And surrounding me now were giant mountains unknown, with dense, green forests at their feet. Sprawling lakes, snow-capped mountains. I made haste as I fled the witch's cave, finding shelter beneath the pines, with a small fire and a sword by my side. I laid upon the ground, where in the sky I could see the spine of night. As the forest slept, so would I. And drift peacefully into the quiet of this quiet night. Alive in the fading twilight. There were deer all around me who had made their beds around my fire that night, slowly waking and seemingly gleeful from a night without the threat of predators. They spoke thanks with their eyes as they began to seek out their breakfast within the leaves. And then I felt the sun cresting the tips of the mountains unknown, its warmth like a fountain. Washing darkness clear and pristine, I could see the shadows of the macabre, the curses of the witch, all being destroyed and dispelled by something which I could now feel guiding me forward as I walked into this new land. onto a new journey, into a new dawn.
Once again, return to Winterstead.